for subject of thermal engineering. So in this subject we are today interested to go for concept of formation of steel and the different terms which are associated with steel. We know, we already seen a TS diagram, TH graph, jahan pe humne observe kiya tha, as per the temperature what we observe, so there is rise in temperature at the same time, sometimes there are changes in phases also. We started from -10 degrees Celsius se dekhe hum log 100 degree Celsius tak gaye the. That concept is called as formation of steel. Aaj usse hum log notes ke through padhna chahenge. Chaliye dosto, start karte hain aaj ke session ke saath. This is me Joshi sir, a warm welcome to all of you to Success Engineering Classes. Sure, so please go through the video completely. बीच-बीच में मैं कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट ट्रिक्स या पॉइंट्स बताते जाऊंगा जो आपको न्यूमेरिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इंपॉर्टेंट होंगे. एंड एट द सेम टाइम इट विल बी रियली इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन हम लोग करने की बात करेंगे. श्योर आई विल बी डिवाइडिंग वीडियोस इनटू शॉर्ट इंटरवल्स सो दैट आपको पूरा का पूरा एक वन आवर का वीडियो नहीं मिलेगा. इट कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू 10 मिनट्स 15 मिनट्स वीडियोस सो दैट इट विल बी इजियर एस्पेक्ट फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड. श्योर चलिए starting with sharing of the screen, notes, what students have requested, sir, to start with formation of steel at a constant pressure from water. Sure, yahan se hame start karna hai pakka. Sir, it is the simplest concept what we already studied. Chaliye ek time just go through karte hai isme se. Consider 1 kg of water at 0 degree Celsius contained in a piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, what is important one, maintained at a constant pressure. That is very important term, because whenever pressure remain constant, we should keep an important point in our mind, ke boiling point remain constant. Sure, that is a very important point that everyone should have in mind. Pakka sab sabne dimag mein rakhna hai. If we heat the water contained in that cylinder, obviously it will be converted into steam. Obviously, whenever water is converted into steam, we know the volume of water increases slightly. Obviously, with increase in temperature, that's true. The volume of water, what we can see here, the volume of water will increase slightly with increase in temperature. Sahi baat hai, good. It will cause the piston to move slightly upwards and hence work is obtained. Hope so. This is a very simple phenomenon. Everyone has understood the part. Vertical and water, which is available at 0 degree Celsius, it is kept in an close arrangement of piston cylinder. So volume was defined one, so pressure was maintained. And when we are going to heat the water, we are going to provide heat to the water. Obviously, at its boiling point, water will be converted into steam. But we know the different proportions of water and steam. Water, when it is in liquid state, occupies a less volume as compared to that steam. When you are going to consider the same volume of water which is converted to steam, we know as a gas it is going to occupy more volume. So we can say the important line is the volume of water will increase slightly. Obviously, at the same time there is also increase in temperature, because we have started with 0 degree Celsius and now we obtained the steam. And for you can say, to obtain on steam, to achieve the steam, we should know the water should reach to its boiling point, that is of 100 degree Celsius. Sure. Now ab iski wajah se kya hoga, it will cause the piston, since volume badh gaya na bhai sahab, cylinder to move nahi ho sakta. So what is the one parameter which is available, that is a piston. So it will cause piston to move slightly upwards and hence we can say work is obtain. This is the most important concept of formation of steam. Now what will happen, this increase in volume of water, or due to which the work is calculated, work is done, is generally neglected for all type of calculations. So ye jo chhota sa volume increase hua hai at boiling point due to conversion, at evaporation point, wo generally hum log neglect karte. To aap bolenge fir neglect karte to kaam kya karna hai, that is the important parameter जो हम सबको समझ के लेना है. अभी देखिए मजा आने वाला है. ऑन फर्दर हीटिंग, ऑन फर्दर हीटिंग वी कैन से टेंपरेचर रीचेस टू बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. गुड, द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर एट नॉर्मल एटमॉस्फेरिक टेंपरेचर, दैट वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस, वी अगेन रिपीट इट. व्हाट इज एटमॉस्फेरिक टेंपरेचर, इट इज 1.013 बार. सही बात है, And we know at a constant pressure of atmospheric pressure, when we are going to keep atmospheric pressure as constant, the boiling point is calculated as 100 degrees Celsius. Sure. Now, something very important thing is that, but it increases with the increase in pressure. Are you getting my point? It increases with increase in pressure. So, जैसे जैसे हम लोग pressure बढ़ाते जाएंगे, वैसे boiling point increase होते जाएगा. So, this is the important point that everyone has to keep in his mind. Whenever we go for increase in pressure, whenever we go for increase in pressure, the ultimate effect of increase of pressure will result in increase of boiling point also. So, when boiling point is reached, the temperature remains constant. That everyone knows. We have seen the graph. Sahi baat hai, the water evaporates at constant pressure only. But now the important thing occurs. Please focus on the part. Consequently, the specific volume of steam increases. Sure, that we know. At this time, at this stage, the steam will have some particles of water in suspension, and it is termed as an wet steam. हमने ये स्टेटमेंट कभी नहीं किया कि इट हैज कन्वर्टेड होली इनटू वेपर. व्हाट वी हैव स्टेटेड एट 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस इट हैज स्टार्टेड कन्वर्टिंग इटसेल्फ इनटू वेपर फॉर्म. दैट इज अ प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज इवेपोरेशन प्रोसेस. एंड व्हेनेवर वी स्टार्ट विद दिस इवेपोरेशन प्रोसेस, व्हाट वी डिस्कस, व्हाट वी सी, व्हाट वी फाउंड आउट कि 100% कन्वर्जन नहीं हुआ है. एट दैट टाइम some particles are added into it and it is called as a wet steam. This process will continue till the whole water is converted into wet steam. What is concept of wet steam? So we are having vapor, that is a steam that we are having with us, but at the same time in that steam, in that vapor, we are having some particles of water in suspended form. So we make a statement, steam will have some particles of water in suspension, and then it is termed as an wet steam. Obviously, this process will continue till the whole particles of water which are available are 100% converted into the steam. And when we are going to reach to that particular state, what we can say, yes, यहां से मिलेगा वो स्टेटमेंट आपको. प्लीज देखिए, दिस प्रोसेस विल कंटिन्यू टिल वॉटर, होल वॉटर इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू वेट स्टीम. श्योर. एंड ऑन फर्दर हीटिंग, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, ऑन फर्दर हीटिंग द वॉटर पार्टिकल्स इन सस्पेंशन विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू स्टीम. जो शुरू में हमने देखा था कि कुछ वॉटर के पार्टिकल सस्पेंडेड स्टेज में है, आज वो भी क्या हो जाएंगे, वो भी स्टीम में कन्वर्ट हो जाएंगे. एंड नाउ वी कैन से सच अ फॉर्म ऑफ एंटायर स्टीम, जो अभी ये स्टेट में है जहां पे कोई वाटर का पार्टिकल अवेलेबल नहीं है, इज टर्म्ड एज ड्राई स्टीम और सैचुरेटेड स्टीम. श्योर, दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. एंड प्रैक्टिकली व्हाट वी कैन से, दिस अ ड्राई स्टीम, दिस अ सैचुरेटेड स्टीम विल बिहेव लाइक ए परफेक्ट गैस. श्योर. And on further heating, the temperature of steam starts rising, and steam in such state is called as an superheated steam. Sure. Over to Joshi sir. What we have concluded, what we have found out, dosto, abhi humne yahan pe found out kiya ki there are three different states of steam what we are observing. Initially, we have started with water at available at 0 degrees Celsius. Then we have moved it, we have converted it into steam form. We can say evaporation of water is carried out. Sahi hai. Due to this evaporation, what we can say, since it is carried out at a constant pressure and it is carried out at an atmospheric pressure, constant atmospheric pressure. We know what is constant atmospheric pressure. It is 1.013 bar. Sahi hai. And when we are converting this water into steam, we say the process is known as evaporation process. And whenever we deal with that evaporation process, what we found out, sir, 100% water is not converted into steam, but some water particles are available in suspended form. And this state and the state where we are having some steam. So water has evaporated, but not completely. Some water particles are suspended in that form. Then that type of steam, that form of steam is known as wet steam. Sure, but it is an evaporation process, and we are going to continue with evaporation process by providing heat to it continuously. And at the end of the day, we see that yes, the 100% water particles are now evaporated and converted into steam. No water particles are available in suspended form. Then we say that it is in a state which is called as an dry state. Dry state, or we can say it is known as a dry steam or saturated steam. So it is a steam where 100% water particles are evaporated into vapor form. Sahi baat hai? So after conversion of this dry steam or saturated steam, what we can say, so again we are going to continue with providing heat to it, and due to effect of it, it is now converted into another form, and that another form is called as an superheated steam. That another form is called as an superheated steam. So we're getting what I'm talking about. So again, we're interested to see the perfect definitions of this dry steam, superheated steam, and anyone? Yes, that is super wet, dry, superheated. And at the same time, we go through some important definitions. So be ready with those part, be ready with that thing, but not in this video. We are going to make another video in which we get that part. So till this point, if you have got the concept, you are happy with the observation of this video. Agar aapko like karna hai to uske niche ke do button hai bhai sahab, subscribe hai and ek bell icon hai, use dabaiye, usse aapko agla video ka turant ek naya link mil jayega. And agar abhi maine kaha acha laga hai to please usse like kijiye. It is important thing. You can share the link to your friends so that they will be benefited. Pakka, this is me Joshi sir recording for our success engineering classes. Actually, this is taken from a live session of thermal engineering. Thank you. I'm just stopping the recording. Bye bye.